My name is Eric Strebel. Welcome to another video of mine about industrial design. Let's talk about ellipses. How do you construct an ellipse and make it look like it's correct in perspective? What I'm doing here is I'm drawing a circle and a box around it. I'm going to end up drawing that very same box in perspective so you can see how the two relate and how to construct a simple ellipse. Drawing a couple of arrows to go down to my vanishing point below us and a vanishing point off to the right where those lines converge. I'm bisecting the circle to figure out the 4 points that the circle touches the square. I'm then showing those points on my square in perspective. And here I am, I'm just sketching in that ellipse. And it's drawn in perspective. What I'm gonna do now to verify everything for you, I'm just gonna grab a ellipse template that I have. So you can see that ellipse. And I'm drawing in, just marking in the short axis. Basically that's pointing to the missing vanishing point in our sketch. So that would be the second vanishing point. What I'm drawing now is a box. The other two sides of the box that would be visible, I'm just guessing, throwing in the other lines that go to the other vanishing points and constructing the rest of that box. I can tell it's a little bit too long. It's not quite a square. Kind of looks like it is, but I think it's a little bit too long. I'm putting in my other points and I'm ghosting in the ellipse here, just like I did the first one. I'm going to get an ellipse guide and I'm going to place it on here to sort of verify what I did. I find an ellipse and place it in there to where it touches the points, and the short axis of the ellipse is going to go after the vanishing point on to the right. I draw in that ellipse, and sure enough, the box is not quite square, and that sort of verifies things. I shorten up the box a little bit to create the backside correctly, and I lay in other points on the top of the box, the 4 points that the circle has to touch, and I draw in my ellipse, and I'm going to get an ellipse template here to sort of verify everything as well, to show how that's pointing down. Looks like it's about a 20 degree ellipse, and I'm ghosting that in. You can see the short axis goes straight down to the vanishing point at the bottom. Now I'm just drawing in some lines here, and I actually draw them incorrect for two of the ellipses. The one I just drew is correct, the one at the top and the one at the bottom. I draw those incorrectly through the circles. And here I correct them. I realize my mistake because the short axis of the ellipse has to go to the vanishing point. So it's easy to make that mistake. And you say, it sure is easy to make that mistake. How does this help me in the real world? How do I draw, for example, a wheel on a car or a vehicle? And I'm going to demonstrate this. We're going to basically draw a line through the two axes of the wheels. We're going to connect the two hubs of the wheels. You can see I'm just sort of laying that out right now, showing you a little bit with my pen where the vanishing point is to the left. On this vehicle, I'm going to draw a line through the two axes of these wheels to sort of reinforce that. Vanishing point off to the left. And I get my circle template, or my ellipse template here, excuse me. And it's about a 40 degree ellipse. And you can see that minor axis of the ellipse is going off to the left to the vanishing point. Now the other wheel in the back is going to have a slightly different ellipse size, probably going to be about 42 or 43 degrees. This photograph was shot with a pretty long lens. If you were drawing sort of freehand, you probably end up putting in like about a 45 degree ellipse in the back there. This photograph was shot with a really long lens, so there's not much of a change, but you do see a little bit more of the back tire opening up as it's a little bit farther away from you than the front one is. Don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel. You can also check out my video on demand series on Vimeo. The link is located below. Feel free to share this video and any other of my videos on your favorite social media site. Thanks. If you like the music in this video, check out Roarlark's Bandcamp site and let them know you like it. Rock on.